Hi guys, I know it's been a while since my last video blog. It's kind of hard during the week for me to make one since I don't really have much time. I work full-time as a web developer, in case you guys didn't know. That means, yes, I'm an IT geek. I just find that after being at work all day, yeah, I just want to relax, and I don't really have that much time anyway in the evenings, just enough time to cook dinner, eat, and do something relaxing like watch a movie, watch TV, or go to the gym, go to dance class. So that's pretty much my week. It's really quite warm today. I think the weather forecast was for 29, and it's certainly more than that in here. The ventilation isn't very good, so yeah, it's quite warm. You probably notice I've got Poppy here with me, keeping me company. He's actually been wired here. If you look a bit closer, he's making himself useful to me today as my official mic holder. Okay, hopefully today's video blog is going to be a little bit shorter than last week's. Yeah, I don't know if I can last sitting in this room for much longer. It's just really hot in here. Alright, well today I'm going to talk about working out. This is something that I really enjoy doing in my spare time, after work in the evenings. I only joined a gym about 4 years ago. Back then, it was because I found that my fitness levels weren't very good for dance class. I'd get puffed quite easily during a routine. So myself and my girlfriend decided to join a gym together. It was a female-only gym in Sydney, and yeah, we used to just go to class together and do a workout session during lunchtime or after work. And that was quite fun. At first it was quite hard for me to get motivated to go and do some exercise. You know, like most people, I just had days where I just wanted to go home, relax and yeah, just eat and sleep and be lazy. But yeah, I soon realised that going to the gym, I would actually feel a lot better than if I didn't. And now I just really love it. I love the high that I get after I go to the gym. My body feels great. It's a great stress release. You feel refreshed, you feel relaxed, energized, and yeah, your body just thanks you for it afterwards. So everyone should do some exercise. I guess it's a personal choice for everyone. And for me, I promised myself that I would never get lazy or fat. When I first came to London about a year ago, I basically became really unfit. I gained about 6 or 8 kilos. I lost heaps of muscle tone, and general strength and energy levels just went, you know, down the drain. And I guess I just made a promise to myself that I really didn't want to become like this. So over the past couple months, I've really put in effort to get into the routine of going to the gym regularly. The gym I currently go to in London is called LA Fitness. I go to the gym on Monday nights. I try to go more than once a week, but at the moment I'm just not managing it, not with dance class and other commitments during the week. My gym is fairly close to work. Normally I would catch a bus there, but yeah, I've decided to kind of start running a bit more. So I run about halfway to the gym, and then when a bus comes along I just hop on it and catch a bus the rest of the way. Then at the gym I do 10 minutes on the rowing machine. I usually end up rowing about 2 kilometers, and then after that I do some stretches, and after that I go on the cross training machine for about 20 to 25 minutes, and then do a heck of a lot more stretches. I'm really, really into stretching to maintain my flexibility for dance. And then after that, I go to a body pump class, which is from 8 to 8:45. That helps to increase my muscle tone and strengthen the muscles again. After that, I do more stretches again. And then, yeah, I'd finish off with about 10-15 minutes in the sauna and then a shower. So that pretty much takes up the whole of Monday night for me. There are a few other classes that I like to do as well. I used to go to a Pilates class regularly, and also yoga. I like to do that as well. In Sydney, I used to do this class called Body Balance. They don't have it over here, unfortunately, but it was my absolute favorite class. It's part of the whole Les Mills, I'm not sure how you pronounce that, but that program, which includes body combat and body pump and body balance. For those that don't know, body balance is a combination of yoga, Pilates and Tai Chi. It's an absolutely fantastic class with about 5 minutes of relaxation at the end. You just feel so relaxed and stretched out, and yeah, it's really great. And I just wish that somebody would run that class here. And of course, I also go to dance classes, and that's also really great for my fitness. Usually, during the warm-ups, they make you do push-ups and sit-ups. During this week, I decided to take my video phone into the gym with me, and so I took some footage of myself doing some stretches. These stretches I learnt from dance class mainly, but I also learnt some of them from doing yoga. So it's kind of a combination of yoga-style stretching. They're pretty intense stretches.
Smile like you've got nothing to prove. No matter what you might do, there's always someone out there cooler than you. I know that's hard to believe, but there are people you meet. They're into something that is too big to be expressed through their
Okay, I've kind of noticed that on YouTube there seem to be a lot of girls who like to do some booty shaking. Now, that's totally up to them. It's their prerogative, whatever they want to do. But what I am surprised at is that the majority of YouTube viewers seem to have absolutely no idea what good dancing really is. Yeah, I'm sorry to say that most of the girls that I've seen dancing on YouTube can't actually dance. They kind of make their movements look sexy, but what they're doing is not real dancing. Real dancing requires skill, timing, being able to isolate your movements properly. Granted, some of these girls can shake their booty quite well, and generally they can make themselves look sexy in a skimpy top and a mini skirt. But, most of them can't even manage to do a proper body roll. Body rolls actually aren't that easy. You need a fair amount of ab muscle and just general muscle tone throughout your body to be able to do a body roll correctly. If you want to see some real dancing, you guys should check out my favourites. I've linked to a number of dance class videos of a teacher called Luam. She teaches hip hop at the Broadway Dance Center in New York, and the dancers in her class are just absolutely awesome. That is what real dancing is. Not some teenage girl trying to sway her body from side to side. fling her arms about. And hump the air.
Look at me, ish, you ain't blind.